I guess what we're together today for is really to talk about you. And when I say you, your fitness, yourself, and how do you really feel? Because that's the only place that you live in, yourself, your body. It's very important that we really look towards it and look after it, and that's the reason why we are together here, and we're going to spend the next time, little time, and it's not likely to be a session where I'm going to just keep talking and you're likely to be passive listeners. I would highly encourage each one of you to be participative. Please feel free to ask your questions. We have a mic here. It'll reach you in no time. And more importantly, for a while, just disengage in your mind. Think about yourself. You got up in the morning, you got to office, and would you feel happier, enriched today if you probably had a workout or you ate right or you got your right sleep? So I'm just going to leave you with a little bit of these thoughts, and then we'll progress in the discussion that we're going to be in. What does physical fitness really mean to you? What, according to you, is physical fitness? And I'd like to invite some answers there. What does it mean to you? It could be as lame as whatever, but please feel free to, you know, take that answer. What is physical fitness according to you?
Being active.
Being active. That's a good one. Very important.
Not be a laziness.
Sorry?
Not be a laziness.
Not being lazy. Absolutely. No, not being lazy, being active. Any other suggestions? Yeah. Anything else that you want to say that, you know, physical fitness means this to you?
To be healthy.
To be healthy. Perfect.
Six pack.
Wow. I wanted to get that answer. Exactly. Right there. Six pack. Just being fit. And there's nothing wrong with that answer.
Yeah.
I think it's an aspiration. And it's important to have goals. And this is one of those goals that you have. And if you don't have these goals, you won't walk through the various goals. So this is good too. And yes, not that active and lazy is not important, equally important. You're going to start right there. Okay, I think all your answers are correct. Physical fitness is really the general state of health and well-being. Very important. Can I get up? I go to take a flight. I have to pick up my bag and throw it on the, you know, on the aisle, the cabin luggage section. Can I do it myself or do I need help? Do I have the strength to pick up that much weight? Am I being able to mobilize myself to be able to accomplish those things? That's important. So the ability to perform, whether it is your occupation, your daily activities, every little task that you need, along with that, can you probably pick up a sport and can you play that sport? That's physical fitness as well. Your ability to perform in a gym, outside the gym, in a sport, run or probably swim or ride, all of these. There are sections, there are three important aspects which are very important to get you the right kind of physical fitness. And that is proper nutrition. I think there's never, we were discussing that there's never a way how you can outrun a fork. So if you don't eat right, whatever amount of workouts that you do, it really doesn't fall in place. So it's important to eat right. It's important to do some bit of moderate to vigorous physical exercise. And that's where tonabolic also comes in. Sufficient rest, very important. You'll realize yourself out of a lot of abilities if you've not slept well. So sleeping well, getting that desired rest is equally important as much as it is to eat right and to exercise right. So these are some of those things which I wanted you to know, that if these three are important, can we work on these on a daily basis to get our abilities better? Now, having said that, it's very important that I introduce a concept to you called health continuum. Now, it just says that if I did my workout today, am I going to be fit? Or if I developed my bicep and I got my six packs today, am I going to be fit tomorrow? Can I be fit another 2 weeks from now? The answer is a big no. It's a continuum. There's no goal really to health and fitness. It's a journey. We always should be engaged in that journey. And I hope there are some takeaways that you have. If not, I mean, I'm sure everything doesn't get registered, but I would look forward to having seeing a little more fitter, smarter self of at least the population which I'm able to anyway speak with today. Thank you.
Thank you, Ashrita, for your time. And can we give it up for Ashrita?